Welcome racers, welcome everyone, Project Cars 2, Career US Championship of Formula C, Round 2 at Circuits of the Americas. It was round 1 yesterday. It was a bit of disaster in terms of getting used to this car and finding how to drive it. So, without further ado, let's move to the practice session, which is 1 hour long, then qualification, and then the full length of our race, just 10 laps. I will show you my settings. I reduced it to 65. Yesterday, I couldn't get the grips with this car, so I had to reduce it. I'm going to keep it for this track at that level, see how it goes. And opponent aggression, I was driving at 100 for all tier 6 races I did, but I found that AI behavior is a bit strange at 100. They cut corners, go through the grass, they crash sometimes. So this is to 80. I'm not sure if this is going to be good enough, or maybe it needs to be reduced further. We will see. Let's save it and let's start. I may increase the difficulty if I find out that I feel better driving that car. What I'm going to do, I'm going to use the settings I was using showing me Indianapolis, why we are at Circuits of the America. This game behavior is quite strange. Anyway, maybe because I have settings for that. I'm going to save it to a new slot, so it's under Circuits of Americas as well. Okay, so name. It's Kota. Ricas, Formula C, 6. Start my dashboard. Let's do a few laps around the truck. I just had the dashboard for some reason. it open on my second monitor, which I cannot see at the moment. This one. Okay, here we go. That car doesn't like those curbs at all. And also this lap will be invalidated because of my mistake in the last sector on the previous lap, which invalidated the previous lap and this one. The previous one was the out lap anyway, so it doesn't really matter. I managed to warm up the front tires, the rear are still a bit cold. That would be 2 minutes 16 seconds. The rear tires are now also warm. This is on the 4th of the 6 gears, I may need to look into the gear setup. 2:13.6, and I'm first. So that difficulty level, which was quite alright for the first round in on Indianapolis, maybe actually way too low for this truck. Left rear tire is the coldest one, but the differences are quite small. We may actually reduce the pressure a little bit on that tire. Find a better angle entry to negotiate the turn. Okay, so we have more than a second advantage. That's way too much. I'm going to exit, and I'm going to increase the difficulty. Also, I need to increase the cooling. I just lost 3% on my engine. So I'm going to increase it to 80. Like at 80. It's 1.8 liter per lap. 18 liters should be enough for the whole race. 19 including the outlap. So let's load that setup we saved. Let's put in some modification. Retire, going to reduce it a little bit. Okay. Fuel, 19 liters. That will be the race setup. Now this gearbox is let's see how that's going to look like. fifth gear here. Third, fourth, fifth. We won't be using sixth at that stage. Sixth. Can I go full speed here? Yeah, I can actually. As long as the entry angle is good in that corner, I don't have to slow down. That would be 2 minutes 15, so it's not as good as the previous one. It was invalidated anyway, and the tires are only catching the temp. This one is going to be invalidated too. The tires are warm. So the times should be better and better. Thank you. 14.4. It's 12.7 and I'm first. Of course I used that slipstream to my advantage on that previous lap. Those curves are really brutal on that truck, on this truck. The guy in front of me is fifth, so... that gives me a good understanding of where my time is in comparison to their times. Of course, I'll have a better one once I see the live timing. What he was going to beat. There was so much on the left.
Check confirm, we got that, we'll go.
That little touch between us had an impact on my aero. I'm 9% down, so I need to go to the pit. Okay, let's see the session. So that's 212.7 was kind of accident because I had a good slipstream when I achieved that. 213.6 was what I achieved without slipstream, just being having a clean air in front of me. So I think that may be actually a good difficulty level. They will improve their times for the qualification. I'm not sure what to expect in the race from them. I may increase the difficulty by another 5 for the race itself, but keep it as it is for quali. We've got another hour. What I want to do is to increase the cooling. We have 47 degrees on the track and 29 ambient. So we're overheating that car. I'll open it to 90%. Save it. Is there anything else we want to modify at that stage? Maybe reduce it further a bit on all four tires. By a few clicks here and there. And I'll give it another try. See if the temps are a bit higher. I want them to be a bit higher. I want them to be above 90. Above 90 degrees Celsius. Second gear seems to be the best solution for that left tight left hander, but maybe I should try the first one. I mean the first gear on the next lap just to see how it feels. To 13.8. The brake ducts are too big. Those brakes are constantly cold. They barely ever hit 300 degrees. And 300 degrees Celsius is a minimum temp you want on your brakes. Even on the heavy braking, they didn't reach 400 and went straight below 300, which means they are cold and they're not as effective as they could be. Okay, I'm catching some slipstream again. Let's see what the time is going to be. 2:12.679. So slipstream gives me that extra 0.8, I guess, something like that. I'm catching slipstream now on the back straight. And we have our results straight away. Green sector. Unfortunately, but I think I feel comfortable now on the truck. I also don't think I need the rest of the session. I'm going to skip to end and we'll continue to qualifying. Looks like my teammate was second during the practice, so I'm going to get rid of some of the fuel. I said 1.8, right? 3.6, 7.2, that's 4 laps pretty much. So let's save it as a quali. I'm having slicks actually, authentic by weather. I prefer to choose my tires myself. Slicks, 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 slicks. Also, only that one was automatic by weather. Strange. Let's resave. Okay, let's try to qualify on pole.
Steady on the outlap. Warm the tyres up before you start pushing hard.
Cold tires plus that curb. Have to be very careful on those curbs. Especially at the full throttle. It will bite back. I have just noticed that the truck is much colder. It was more than 40 degrees during the practice. It's only 31 degrees during this qualification. So it definitely will be much harder to warm up the tires. more than 10 degrees difference on a truck. Come on, let's take pole. 53 degrees on tires, so they actually still cold. I will have to be more careful with throttle when exiting the corners. The car is sliding, but maybe that will help me get some more temps in those tires. On all tires. 70 is the good minimum. So we're still below a good working temperature for the tires. I think that will be around 214, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. It's a little bit time, I'm 16th. Front tires are in green now. The rear tires need just a little bit more, like a few degrees. Thank you. first with 2:13. .696 to be exact. Try to improve it further, just in case. It's 6 minutes to the end of the session, so I want to make sure I have that pole position. All four tires are in green, nice and warm. Car is light, just 1 liter of fuel left. To 12.941. I have half a liter fuel left, so there's no point trying to do another lap time. Just deliver the car back to the pit.
Roger that, box this lap.
Try to save some fuel. .1 liter of fuel. No fuel left based on the dashboard. And the Motec. Here we go. Run out of fuel. Flatbed and back to... Oh, they're actually quite... They're doing horrible times, 2:14. They were quicker in the practice. Quite interesting, actually. I will definitely increase the difficulty. for the race. That's a huge difference. Okay, let's not wait till the end of the session. Let's skip to end. And that was 212.9 versus 214. Where's my teammate? Okay, continue to race.
That's a great first lap, nice job. Now try and extend your lead. fastest first sector you've done so far. Great stuff. Just at your own personal best lap. Keep it up.
At first sector, I'm losing a lot there. I can gain quite a lot in the second one and the third. But at first one, horrible. Those quick S's are my nemesis. I have some briefing room, not much, one mistake and it's all gone. That's half a race done, half a race to go.
Leading by 3 seconds over second place, that's great. Keep pushing, keep the gap.
Four laps to go. The Formula C is quite strange because in all previous series, AI was slower in the race in comparison to the qualification, which makes sense, right? Different amount of fuel, probably more aggressive setup, especially that I'm driving at a difficulty where they are allowed to change the setup. But in this series, they are faster in race than they were in quali. Even at the same difficulty level, which is 80 at the moment, they are faster in race than they were in qualification. I'm quite consistent with my times, they're all 2 minutes 13 seconds. One was 2 minutes 12 seconds point something, I don't remember what. But I think it was faster than my qualification time, but it wasn't the fastest lap of the race. That's why I think that AI is faster in the race than they were in the qualification. More laps. Lost 8% of the engine durability, though the temperatures are quite good, so that's quite interesting. Tires is quite good, 96% on the front tires, 98% on the rear tires, so just 2 and 3% gone.
We're looking good, just no mistakes and take the win.
2.4 liter of fuel left. Fuel will not be an issue. This is final lap. This wasn't an easy race, a really hard beginning. The first few laps were really hard. And then I was able to gain some advantage, a small gap of around 3 seconds. And then I was able to keep that gap till the end of the race, but I wasn't really able to extend it. I'm really curious what times they were doing during the race. I mean to check the logs post race through the RS Dash application I'm using, which provides me the dashboard plus race statistics. Really great application for sim racing. Let's finish that pull down lap. Really tired, that race really was a hard one. Well, almost missed it. I didn't know that mine is the first one. Best lap 2:12.920. Their best lap was 2:13.240, if I can see. All right. 2:13.233. That's the best lap. They were doing 2:14. Oh, they did 2:14. Possibly 2:14.2 at the qualification. So they were a second quicker, some of them, than they were on quali. That's unexpected and crazy. The weather conditions were better during the qualification as well, I think. It was easier to keep the tires warm and stuff. Really strange situation. My time during the race was the same as during the qualification, more or less. 2:12, high 2:12. Okay, we're done with this race. 26 points. I was fourth in the first one, first in this one. 39 altogether. So I went to the first place in the overall standings. And how about team? Yeah, the team is first as well. Okay, not by much, but still good. Good. It wasn't easy. Really wasn't. I'm curious what is the third race. I may not have time to do it now. Probably won't have time to do it. So I'll do it probably tomorrow. This is Road America. I really like this track. I think it's a great racing circuit, but I'm not sure how it's going to be in this part of the car. I'm going to keep the same setting, 75-80. I lowered it from 100 because they were crushing into me like crazy at higher. They still crush into me at 75. I don't know what's going on. Sometimes it's just a track, you know. Some tracks you can do 80 difficulty and it's barely, and some tracks you can do 100. And yeah, I adjusted basically the whole championship. I like the challenge, but I don't like when it goes crazy. Okay, thank you all for watching, and I see you next time at Road America of the Formula C US Championship. Have a good evening.